Before there was Geralt, there was Vesemir. Before season 2 of The Witcher, we have a movie to talk about. Let's do it. What is up, Netflix fans? Welcome back to my channel. The Witcher, Nightmare of the Wolf, is on Netflix right now, at least when this video is going up. I want to say thank you to Netflix for providing me a screener. And my goodness, this was a nice surprise. Won't give anything away. Spoiler free, of course. Let's get into it. The world of The Witcher expands on Netflix in this anime origin story. Before Geralt, there was his mentor, Vesemir, a swashbuckling young witcher who escaped a life of poverty to slay monsters for coin. But when a strange new monster begins terrorizing a politically fraught kingdom, Vesemir finds himself on a frightening adventure that forces him to confront the demons of his past. First of all, I want to give kudos to the cast here. Theo James as Vesemir does a wonderful job. He has the exact voice that you expect with a character like this. Graham McTavish is great. Laura Pulver is awesome as Tetra. And there are so many characters of note here, but this takes place before the time of Geralt. And the character of Vesemir is making, of course, his live-action debut in season 2 of The Witcher. And there's going to be so much about this movie that won't necessarily play in plot point to plot point when it comes to season 2 of The Witcher, but you're going to know so much about Vesemir, what he went through in this film, and the tragedies of his past. There is a romance in this movie that I thought worked expertly well, and the way that everything leaves us off was just incredibly touching and emotional. My goodness, but spoiler-free review, let's talk about the positives. The animation is really good in this movie. It's one thing that I was fearful of. Oftentimes, these Netflix anime films, if you want to call it that, they provide us with various types of animation, sometimes really good, sometimes the animation and the art style doesn't work as well. This time around, it's great, but it's also pushing the boundaries. It's an extremely violent film. It's as hard R or TVMA, as you expect. I mean, the first scene alone, we see a family get just completely decimated and slaughtered, and we see that violence transpire, and you immediately know the threat is there, right? That's the plot point that's going to carry over. But as we continue on, we get a bit of the backstory of Vesemir, not only a bit of a romance, a bit of a fling as a child, but how that carried into he as an adult, but what he went through, the trials of becoming a witcher. He has his first experience witnessing what a witcher can do, and he gets a piece of advice. Witchers do not hesitate, and that's the point. He even says, let me come with you, right? But he says, no, you're not ready yet. You have something, a piece of your life that is stopping you. But then we see him actually go through those trials and become kind of the legendary witcher he is today, which of course is technically the past because where we are with Geralt in the series. But it's nice to see a lot of fleshed out backstories. Even though a lot of the film is taking place in that flashback, I'm okay with that because you're building up characters and you're getting a lot of depth in that way. But then we come back to the present. We see him go on this journey, this mission. He feels betrayal. He feels all of these different forces coming at him at once. And he is a very headstrong and at times overly adamant character. But there's definitely a soft spot, and we see that kind of play out in the third act. We see that soft spot hit upon by our villainous character, and I won't dive into details on who he's actually fighting. But there are a lot of things about the lore, and that's kind of where I want to go next, that if you are a fan of this character and just this world in general, then I think you're going to find, obviously, a lot out of this movie. But this is also a nice starting point, in my opinion. You may see some reviews that contradict this, but I actually have to disagree. For those who are just wanting to watch this film out of curiosity as to what The Witcher is, and you're a fan of anime or just the style of animation, I think this may be a good starting point because you learn kind of what a Witcher is, what a Witcher can do. You see various forms of that in this film, but it also dives into the lore of this world and what a coin actually is, what it does. We learn a little bit about the elves. We learn a little bit about the humans, the conjuring of these witches, these demonic characters that provide for awesome visuals, but at the same time give you insight as to what this world is. And it is also, and it's not really built for this, but it plays as a transition from season 1 to season 2 because obviously the character of Vesemir is going to play drastic importance into that. So It's a nice bridge film. It's a film that stands on its own. It's a great origin story. There's a lot of emotion and conflict that comes at the end. We get this huge battle of all of these villainous characters taking on a group of witchers. And if that sounds epic, the battle is as epic as it sounds. A lot of blood, a lot of gore, a lot of violence, and my goodness, guys, what a surprise this movie was. I thought I would like it. I just didn't know how to feel about it. But I want more, and if this thing plays like I believe it will play, we're going to get more. Before I give you guys my score, I want to say thank you so much for watching. Like I said, if you like this review and you want to see me cover more things on Netflix, be sure to drop your thumbs up down below. Whether you are a hardcore fan or just starting out, this film works extremely well. It does a wonderful job of building onto the lore and providing compelling relationships between characters. I do believe the story does somewhat lose some luster in the second act. It wasn't as compelling as the opening or as emotional and shocking as the ending, so the second act is the clear weakness for me. But overall, a really, really solid addition to this lore. I'm going a 78% for my score. So obviously, if you're a fan of The Witcher, it's a must-see. But again, if you're not, could be a bit of a starting point. I'm really excited for season two, guys. I am so thrilled. I love the idea that they're doing this. If they can give me more compelling stories, whether they take place way before or at another time period, but this is a character I can't wait to see more of. I hope there's that consistency transferring over into live action. All right, you're the best. Many things to come on Netflix this week. And later on today, Shang-Chi. Tell, got my pop figure sitting out. Is there a Spider-Man trailer today? You're supposed to be. I'll see you soon.